Hello and welcome to Class A, a learning and support resource for industrial Class A surfacing. My name is Adam and today's Class A is about a geometry type we call the conic. I'll be looking at how conics can help make cleaner, lighter surfaces and more reliable at that. So, anybody who knows my friend Don knows that Don loves conics. As a superstar Class A surfacer, Don knows that conics make his geometry lighter, cleaner, and more reliable, and we at Class A love conics too. And this tutorial will be the first in a series explaining why we surfacers love these shapes so much, and how you can use them to create Class A surfaces of your own. So, what is a conic? Simply stated, a conic is the intersection of a cone and a plane. This means that it's a simple, predictable curve. It's always planar, it's always convex, and always second order. So, conic sections can include ellipses, parabolas, hyperbolas, and technically even circles and arcs, though circles aren't usually thought of as conics. These shapes are surprisingly powerful and often underutilized by beginners, in my opinion. There are many advantages to the use of conics in your CAD models. For one thing, a conic is a second-order curve, meaning that the math is very lightweight, and so it will help keep your file sizes smaller and make them very fast to regenerate if you're using a parametric package. Because they're always planar, conic sections create very clean swept surfaces when used with a clean spine, which we'll go over in detail in a future tutorial. And thirdly, conics can appear attenuated, give you the power to control their apparent sharpness, similar to a tension value in a other spline-based G1 or G2 continuous curve. As I mentioned before, unlike G2, a conic will never OG or wobble. A conic's curvature acceleration will always be smooth and always positive. And lastly, there are many ways to define conics in space, and probably more than you've ever considered so far. We're not going to go over nearly all of them here, but we'll get a little preview. So, here are a few of the most common ways of defining a conic section in space. As a surfacer, you'll seldom use most of these, but it's helpful to know that they're available. Some surfacing packages have more conic construction tools available than others. I'm always calling these guys up and saying, why are you limiting my ability to make conics? Most packages will only include a small subset of these, unfortunately. So different tools will give you different advantages. But for Class A surfacing, the most common use for conics will be as a blend between two curves or surfaces. Usually this is accomplished by providing two tangent surfaces and contact points for each, and what is called a rho value to define the curve's sharpness. In other cases, it's not uncommon to use a third contact point instead of a rho value if you have a through point that you need to hit. But what does that mean? What is a rho value and what does it really do? If a conic is an intersection between a plane and a cone, the rho value is the angle of the plane relative to the cone. Right? So by steepening the angle of the plane, the resulting intersection curve will appear sharper. By flattening the plane, the result will appear rounder. A rho value is not expressed as an angle, but it's as a ratio between 0 and 1. A rho value of 0.5 is pretty round. A rho value of 0.9 is very sharp. So you can play with those values and get a tension that you think looks the way that you want it to. In practical use, the most common example of a conic in Class A surfacing, as I mentioned before, is a blend between curves and surfaces. So this does have many advantages over using spline-based G1 and G2 blends. For example, while conic sections can look very much like G2 curves, they always remain perfectly convex as shown here. The G2 curve can be adjusted to correct the inflection that it's showing, but this requires manual manipulation, and you can easily overlook that if the inflection is very subtle. sometimes an inflection will happen in a surface and you don't even notice it. Even with zebra stripes, sometimes you can miss them. So a conic, you know that there can be no doubt that the curvature never inverts. Conic sections with a row value of about 0.65 or higher will usually appear to be smooth visually to the human eye, and the difference between G2 and conic in these cases is virtually non-existent. With a very careful manipulation, the conic with a perfectly calculated row can even actually become mathematically G2 technically in certain cases, but this isn't common at all, and I just want to point out that it can be done in a pinch. Typically, you need to remember that conic blends are tangent continuous, not curvature continuous, and that therefore geometric continuity degradation can occur. So this ends our quick introduction to the world of conics, and in the next series of tutorials we'll be exploring how these beauties work in actual practice using real CAD tools. So thanks for watching, and happy surfacing.